People often ask me how I collect and specifically place the northern paper wasp. I use them for protection for my honeybee apiary. And look what happened. We had a storm last night. We had an inch and a half of rain, winds, thunder, lightning. I come out this morning and what's laying on the deck? This little paper wasp nest. And these are the nurse wasps that are on it. They're females. And they're attending to eggs and larvae in here. So now what do we do? Can we pick them up and put them somewhere else? We sure can, and that's what this video is going to show. This is the overhang of my bee observatory shed, and this is where they fell from. Who knows where they were exactly attached because all the paper came with them. But I'm going to show you how to house and reattach them somewhere of your choosing. They're pretty passive. I'm taking this video very close to them. Of course, it's early in the morning. It's nice and cool. Temperatures are going to rise, and I want to put them in some shelter before that happens. So let's go in the wood shop. I have a scrap bin handy. I'm just going to pull some scraps out of here and make a little shelter for them and attach it to my bee observatory building. Here it is. I'm going to use hot glue. High temp hot glue by Gorilla. So I've stuck these parts together, and we're going to turn it upside down. I'm going to put a dab on it, and I'm going to carry it out here. And there it is, my little glob of hot glue, which is now in the process of cooling. The Gorilla hot glue has a longer working time, so I can grab this little flange with my forceps here, and that will insulate the main part of this nest from the heat of the glue. So we're going to stick that right on there using these forceps, and I am wearing bee gloves just in case. They're passive, but they could deliver a sting, and they do it in a really low-key way. They just land on you and put their stinger in really slow. And here, let's take a close-up look at the paper. Now, one of the reasons this building is popular is because they use the cellulose from it to make their nests, and I want that. I put these little paper wasp nests around my apiary because they displace yellow jackets. They don't like yellow jackets, and neither do I, because yellow jackets will eat my bees. But these paper wasps, they don't eat bees. Look at the larvae in the cells here. You can see them moving around. There are eggs in there. And I'm just positioning this because before I turn it upside down again, I want to make sure it's going to be attached correctly. And they feed these insect pests that they gather from your gardens, the fields, the meadows. They chew them up and bring them back. The adult wasps we're looking at here only drink nectar. They can't eat solid foods. And I want this nest to get bigger, and I want more of them around, because the more of these I have around, the fewer yellow jackets I'll have around. So here it is. They're all in place. That was a very easy procedure. Now I'm going to stick it here, part of the overhang, but I'm going to put it off to the side. And you may be wondering, why the heck are you putting paper wasps right where people are going to come and go? Well, I'm the only person generally who comes and goes from this building. And they won't even care. I've had paper wasps of this species inside the building, right where I sit and take notes and observe my bees and their inner observation hive behaviors. So this is going to be in a perfect spot right here. And because I've put these little side pieces on and a nice cover for them, they'll be able to come and go and not be exposed to the weather, and they can continue to raise their baby wasps. Couple of stainless steel screws in here and we're all done. I could probably use just one, but I'm going to put two in just for kicks. Rough cut lumber. This is pine. You can see the edge of the pine tree still on it. And I use this for a lot of my random projects around dealing with insects. And I have other boxes full of these in my apiary. They don't bother the honeybees at all. Now let's take a close-up look at the nest. You can see their eggs right in the closest cells. And they have hexagonal cells, much like honeybees do, only these, instead of being made of wax, are made out of cellulose and their saliva. Fun, huh? This is the environment that they're in. We have a nice big meadow here, some early linden trees there, and the sun's coming up. Let's take a closer look inside some of these cells. We can see this female worker is feeding the larvae there. The larvae move around, and they do, as I mentioned before, consume little caterpillars, they consume bugs, spiders, insect pests. They get pre-chewed by these female workers. So when they go out and snatch something to feed these larvae, they chew them up first, discard the feed and the non-essential parts, and then they just feed the little pellets of protein to these developing larvae. So here we are. Now look, we've disrupted them, we've reattached the nest, and they're very passive. They don't even care that I'm here taking this video. So that's how you do it. It wouldn't matter if there was a larger group. Early in the spring, you'll see a little pine cone shaped nest, and sometimes they'll just be getting started and you'll just see the queen. And then later on, the workers will hatch out and then they'll start taking over the duties of feeding this larvae. And look at them in there. Look at the eggs. So what I'll do, probably later on, give you updates on the nest as they develop and more hatch out. And pretty soon there's a bunch of them, but that's how you relocate a paper wasp nest. I appreciate that you took the time to watch this, and yellow jackets are little jerks, but when it comes to friendly wasps that you want to keep around, these northern paper wasps are fantastic. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.